What's going on, guys? Seancutshair back with another video. A few weeks back on one of my haircut tutorials, Alexis left a comment, can you make a more detailed styling video? Like how to use product, cocktail products, how to use different speeds, heats on the blow dryer. I'm trying to be like you, the cut and finish was fire. So in today's video, I'm gonna break down some of the techniques that I use. Guys, years ago, I bought a Dyson blow dryer. It was 400 bucks, and I really challenged myself to get better at styling. So nothing I've ever been professionally trained in. These are just techniques that I figured out on my own and basically how I've learned to use these products in my own way and kind of how I like to do things. So I'm gonna go over some of the products that I use, some of the tools that I use, and I will even show you guys some clips of doing this in a haircut so you guys can see how it's done. First off, guys, I did go back to the Dyson blow dryer. I just got this week. And guys, I have so many nice tools. I just didn't love using my $40 Dyson knockoff blow dryer. So I did invest in another Dyson. And guys, it is better. The other one does get the job done. If you guys didn't see that video and you wanna check out the knockoff Dyson, click the card up above. But guys, I did pick up another Dyson. And this blow dryer is fire, guys. I absolutely love it. Most of the time I'm gonna use it with this attachment on it, guys. This is just a nozzle that is gonna aim the hair in the direction that you want. And when combined with a round brush or a vent brush, you can really work the style out. If I wanna just dry the hair faster, guys, I will take the nozzle off and use the blow dryer like this and really just move air fast and loose and get that hair dried nice and quick. Last but not least, guys, the diffuser. This is what I'm gonna use for my crop top to bring out texture and also to bring curls back out. And like I said, I'll show you guys some clips in the end of us using. But really depending on the style that you're trying to do will determine which nozzle or diffuser that you guys wanna use. Now, as far as heat settings go, the Dyson has three heat settings and it has three speed settings. Most of the time I use it on full speed and full heat. Sometimes, guys, you wanna be careful not to damage the hair. If it's gonna take a while to dry, I will knock that down. But if it's just damp and I'm gonna get it dry pretty quick, I will use it on full heat and full speed. Now, if I'm using the diffuser and I want things to dry a little bit slower, I will use it on a lower speed and a lower heat. Just depends on what you guys wanna do. So if you really wanna get that style done quickly, obviously the higher the heat and the higher the speed, the faster it will go. If you guys wanna take your time, definitely try a lower setting. Now, if you guys are trying to style with this on full speed, it will absolutely blow the hair in the direction that it's pointing. So sometimes you will need to lower the speed so that you have a little bit more control over the hair. This thing will literally blow the hair right out of the round brush that you're using. So use those accordingly, guys, based on the style that you're trying to do, and you guys should have no problems. So we've talked about the blow dryer, guys. I'm gonna show you some tools that I use. This is a vent brush. The vent, meaning it has holes in it, guys. Basically, we can use it to hold the hair. The air will go through the brush and dry the hair as we style. Now, guys, this is a round brush. I did used to have a smaller one, but I don't really use a round brush anymore. I have gotten better with my vent brush, and I can get most of my work done with this. But you guys can get a smaller round brush, and you basically twist it in the hair, and the hair will work its way over it. And with the blow dryer, you guys can create that flip in the front. I actually use a round brush right now to get the back of my little mullet mohawk to flip out at the bottom. But most of the time I'm gonna use the vent brush, guys. It has good enough bristles that I can grip the hair to really create the flow that I want and get that hair styled nice and easy. Now for my crop tops, and once I have product in the hair and it is already blow dried, I like to use a wider tooth comb. So you guys can see here, this is a StyleCraft wide tooth, and this is obviously still kind of wide tooth, but these are the big pointy teeth. I like to use this to style crop tops, and sometimes I'll just put the product in and comb the hair back down with this. If you use a regular comb like my YS Park, it will catch in that product. You're pulling your client's hair and it's just not too easy. So I like to use a wide tooth. This is currently what I'm using. Here's some examples, guys. This is another StyleCraft wide tooth comb. It has a little bit finer teeth. And then this comb, guys, you've seen it before. I got this on Amazon, just another wide tooth comb. So I like to use it to comb crop tops down, like I said. It kind of gives it the start of some texture, then you guys can kind of just shake it out and get it how you want. So like I said, guys, we will use all of this stuff in the video coming up and you guys can see how it's all put to use. So last but not least, I'm gonna tell you guys some of my products that I'm currently using. Guys, there are so many products, so don't think that you have to use these exact ones, but basically the type of product that it is what I'm gonna teach you guys about and why I use it. So first up, guys, this is a product from Blowdrying. It is called Ascend. It is a volume cream and a heat protectant. So most of the time, if I'm doing a style that's gonna require quite a blow dry and I don't wanna damage the client's hair, I will apply some of this. And guys, I do wet the hair, apply the product, and then start the blow dry. This is also really good for bringing out curls. If you have somebody that has curly hair, we comb it out to cut it with scissors and it gets really straight on us. You guys can apply this again to wet hair, get the diffuser out, and we'll get the curls worked back up. Next up, guys, if I want a shiny product, this is Level 3 Pomade. It's gonna give a very nice shiny product, definitely for like a slick back or pompadour or a comb over. You guys can use this, it works very well. It will actually do a decent amount of holds. So sometimes even if I have a short comb over that I'm gonna style and I don't even need to blow dry it, I can apply this to damp hair, comb it in place, and it will hold all day long. Now this is a pretty shiny product. I don't use it a lot except for those hairstyles. Most of the time I like to use matte finish products that we're about to talk about. So next up, guys, and if you've been following me for a while, you know my favorite clay ever was Tomb 45 Indestructible Clay, and it is no longer on the market. So this is the best one that I've found yet, guys. This is Marmara Space Wax. If you guys have heard of Marmara, they make all the Barber number 1 through 50 aftershave cologne. So Barber number 1, Barber number 9, and this is a product called Space Wax. Now guys, it's not really a wax, it's more like a clay. I'm not really sure why it's called Space Wax, but this is a high hold, zero shine product. So for crop tops, styles like I'm wearing, I like to use stuff with no shine, and I like a decent amount of hold. Now it does say high hold, but honestly guys, it's what's in my hair right now. And you can see I'm able to still move my hair around, but when it sits, it's gonna have a nice finish style. Now I'm gonna use products like a clay and a matte finish on crop tops and textured styles and other styles where the client doesn't necessarily like a shiny product. Now last but not least, guys, if I wanna take the texture to the next level, I like to use 245 Pure Powder. Now guys, styling powder basically acts like a dry shampoo. It is gonna absorb all the moisture that is left in the hair. So if you guys ever have a style that you feel like is too long and it's just not getting the hold that you want, apply some powder. It's gonna give you a nice, firm, but loose hold. So you're gonna be able to shake it around. I like it for longer hairstyles, kind of that swept back look where we don't want that perfect combed finish. We can shake this through the hair and it's just gonna give us that nice loose, but also some hold for those longer hairstyles. Now I will add these to crop tops as well, as you guys will see in a minute. We can add it to the top of the crop top again, just to get it that totally dry look, and it's gonna really accentuate the texture. All right guys, so those are some of the tools and products that I use for styling. Let's hop into some clips. I'm gonna break down some of the techniques that I do and how we put these to use, and I hope it helps you guys. All right guys, so you can see we have the Blumon Ascend. This is the heat protectant and texture cream. I'm gonna go ahead and apply it to my gloves, spread it all the way through the hair. I wanna make sure I get it all the way through all parts of the hair, all the way down to the root, and then we can come in with our diffuser. So like I said, this diffuser is gonna help to bring the curls back out. I'm gonna start by just scrunching it with my fingers, as you guys can see. I don't wanna put the diffuser directly on his head yet because it does get pretty hot. So as the hair starts to get dry and it is lifted up off the head, then I can kinda come in and use it like a curl sponge. So you guys will see as it starts to get dry, I'm gonna get that diffuser a little closer, and I'll actually use it in the hair to curl it back up. Now that I've got it mostly dry, guys, I'm going to turn it on cool, and I'm going to come in with it on a cool shot, and this will lock the style in place. So I'm basically doing the same thing, but it is on cool now, and you guys see I'm just going to work that all the way through and give it that finished style. Now I'm gonna put a little bit of the Level 3 pomade on top. Like I said, this is the shiny product. I just worked a little bit in my fingers and I'm just gonna scrunch it in. That's gonna give it a little bit of hold and also a little bit of shine. I didn't do a whole lot, so you guys aren't gonna notice the shine here, but I just wanted to add a little bit of product, a little bit of smell good, and a finished style. Now we're moving on to a crop top style or a messy textured style. I'm gonna take about a dime size amount of the Space Wax. Again, guys, we want to work it in. I'm gonna spread it through my gloves, warm it up very well. The hair is wet, and then I'm gonna work it all the way through the hair. So you see I'm taking it in every direction, getting it down to the root, all the way down to the scalp, and through the entire length of the hair. Then we can come in and start to blow dry. So hair has a memory. Once hair dries, it is gonna wanna stay that way. So that is why we wet it. And now as I blow dry it, I'm just gonna take it in every direction to make sure that it has no memory, and then we can start to work it as it dries into our finished style. Now, like I said, I really want to accentuate that texture, so I'm going to shake in some 245 Pure Powder. You guys see it's actually looking like it's going everywhere but in the hair. It does like to kind of fly around, but guys, I'm just pulling the hair back and shaking some down in there, and then I'll do a little coat over the top. Now I'm just gonna kind of scrunch it with my fingers, and you guys see it's really gonna dry that hair up, give us a nice finished look, and I can just work that finished style into place. Now we're gonna do a slick back style. Again, guys, this is the Ascend Heat Protectant. This is gonna take a minute to get this style into place, so I wanna use something to protect the hair. It's also gonna give us a little bit of volume. My man has a little bit finer hair on top, and so it's gonna give it some volume. So I have wet the hair, applied the cream, and now I'm just working the hair in the direction using the vent brush and the nozzle that we talked about in the beginning. So the side I want to flow back, the top we're gonna go up and over to the other side. So just little by little, I will use my vent brush to grab the hair and direct it in the direction that I want. You guys will even see on top, I'm gonna lift the hair and use the nozzle to create a little bit of volume. He does like this flat to his head though, so I'm just using the brush to direct the hair where I want, and obviously following it with the blow dryer to start to dry it as we go. Now, honestly, most of the time for this look, I would use a shiny product, but he does not like shiny products. So we are gonna use that same space wax. Again, guys, working it all the way through my hands, making sure it's warmed up and spread out. It's called emulsifying it. You wanna work it till it's almost clear, and then we're just gonna apply it on top, and we can come in with our wide tooth comb and give it a nice finished look. So I'm just combing it into place here. I wanna make sure that the part is nice and neat. I wanna make sure that the crown is laying down, and then we can really get this top combed over and laying in super nice. Now on this next style, guys, we're actually not gonna do a blow dry. I cut the top before I cut the sides. It is actually sitting dry on top of his head. I'm just gonna apply the product, and you guys are gonna see when I put it in, it is really gonna stick up. And this is what I was talking about. So the hair is short enough, I don't need to really blow dry it. He doesn't wear it up and crazy. So I'm just gonna put the product in. Then I'm gonna come in and use my wide tooth comb to comb it back down. And again, guys, a fine tooth comb will catch because of all the product that's in the hair. So the wide tooth comb is just gonna help to lay it down, and then you can work your finished style in. All right, you guys have seen this video on the channel, guys, but same thing here. We're using the heat protectant volume cream. I'm gonna come in and blow dry it in every direction to start to get it to dry. Again, we wanna break that memory that the hair has, and then we can start to work some volume in the back. Specifically, the top is gonna lay down like a crop, but we really wanna bring out that texture in the back. And again, to give it the finished look that we want, we will just shake the powder in. And you guys will really see in this longer hair, it really brings out that texture, dries everything up, and makes it look super nice. On this last one, I want to show you guys, I'm really just going to use the air coming out of the blow dryer to direct the hair where I want. So when I teach my clients how to style their own hair, I show them that really if they just blow the dryer right, it can help create the shape that they want. So now I'm using my vent brush, but you really, if you guys paid attention to the beginning, I can just use the air and it will actually blow the hair that way, like you can see right there. And then I'm just using the vent brush to help it. So we're just creating some lift in the front. Again, guys, we use the heat protectant, the Blumon Ascend on this haircut. And then we'll come in at the end and apply some pomade to give it a nice finished look. Now I want you guys to pay attention to this combination move right here. This is how you're gonna get that nice flowing front on a pompadour or a side part. You guys are gonna use your comb to lift the hair, and you will actually use your other hand to fold it over at the top. And if you guys have blow dried it nice enough and use the right amount of product, you will basically bend that hair with your hand and shape it exactly how you want.
Alright guys, that is it for the styling video. I hope it helped. You guys leave me some feedback down below and some topics that you guys would want to see on the channel. And if I pick your topic, I will shout you out on the channel like I did in this video. We'll put your comment on there and we'll talk about it. If you guys liked the video, do me a favor and smash that thumbs up. Guys, we just hit 40K, so we're well on the way to the 50K giveaway. And if you're not subscribed, now is the time to do so. So hit subscribe, turn on the bell notification so you guys don't miss any content drops from me. Guys, I got the Gold FX Boosted coming up, a huge transformation, and a top three clippers of 2022 video coming soon. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. As always, I appreciate all of you that watch the channel, and I'll catch you guys next time.